Hi everybody, welcome to Back to Viz Basics Flourish Edition. I'm Jon Schwabish from PolicyViz, and I am going to help you learn how to use the Flourish browser-based data visualization tool. If you're not familiar with Back to Viz Basics, well, it's a bi-weekly project every other week run by Eric Balish and Alyssa Davis, both in the Tableau community. And the purpose of the project is to just learn how to create good, effective data visualizations. And the way the project has worked over the past few years is Eric and Alyssa and their team put out a data set. And it could be something as simple as two series over time. It could be a couple of series for a scatter plot. Or it could be a whole bunch of data to be made into a table. And you are asked to go create that graph. And it's primarily for people in the Tableau community, but anybody can participate. And Eric tells me that there's more and more people using Power BI in the project. So that's kind of fun to see. So what happens is they release the data, give you a little summary, and then you go out and create the visualization. And then you share the visualization with them either through the Google form that is available on the Back to Viz Basics site, and tagging them on LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, wherever you share your content on social media. So what we're going to do, or what I'm going to try to do for the Flourish part, is to create these visualizations in the Flourish data visualization tool. Now, if you've never used Flourish, I think it's a really nice tool. It is browser-based, which has its own pros and cons of not being able to save your content locally, but makes it sharing with people a little bit easier. I'm not an expert Flourish user, and so I'm going to be learning how to use this tool along with you. And so I think there are lots of advantages of using a tool like Flourish, where you create your visualizations online in the browser. One, your visualizations are immediately interactive, which isn't always necessary, but sometimes can be valuable, especially in those cases where you want to provide additional content to your reader or to your user. Secondly, a browser-based visualization tool like Flourish allows you to create visualizations that are immediately responsive. So that means on Windows or computers of different sizes, your visualization is going to scale correctly, as opposed to a static visualization, which is just an image, which, you know, you might not be able to see on different monitors of different sizes. The other thing that I like about Flourish is that it's pretty straightforward. There's not a ton of hacking you can do to extend the capabilities, but it's got so much in it, so many different visualization graphs and types in it, and animations and motions and interactivity, that I think if you're creating a fairly finite set of graphs, even going beyond your standard lines and bars and pie charts, you can create a lot of different types of visualizations. So this is how this part of the Back to Viz Basics project is going to work. We're going to start along with the current project, but I'm going to start to backfill each of the first several weeks of the project. And by that, I mean I'm going to create those visualizations, I'm going to share those visualizations, and I'll create a video for each of them. And the first part of that video will be the basics. This is how you move the data into Flourish. This is how you create the basic data visualization. And then the second part will move it a little bit forward, how to add some styling, maybe add some pop-ups, maybe add some interactivity to move it kind of that to that next stage. And I'm hopeful that we will all learn together how to create really good, accessible, interactive data visualizations using the Flourish tool. I also suspect that we'll be finding some things that we'll want to see improved in the tool. And hopefully the Flourish team will be checking it out and will learn from us and reply to some of the things that we want to see in the tool. So every week I will publish a short post on my site on PolicyViz about the Back to Viz Basics project for Flourish. And I would encourage you to share your work with me so that we can learn together. So check out the videos in this series, check out the links below so that you can head over to my site and you can head over to the Back to Viz Basics site and also data to data.world where you can download the data. So you need to do a little bit of work to get started. You're going to need to create a data.world account to get the data, and you're going to need to create an account over at Flourish to create the visualizations. All of that is free. All that is free for you to use and to experiment with and to try on your own. If you have any questions, you feel free to ping me here or on social media, or you can contact me directly through the PolicyViz website. So take a look. I'm excited to learn with you, and we will get back to Viz Basics.